How many have finished their 6 days? Please, you take it seriously. Now, just let me ask you, just to conclude, just out of something on Ramadan, okay? During Ramadan, we had what? A day, right? Not a day, we had the last days of Ramadan. It's called what? The last 10 days is a day. What's that day called? The last 10 days is one important day. What is it called? Laylatul Qadr. And Laylatul Qadr is what? They say it is better than what?
1,000
months. Why? Yes, why? 100 million? So what? One, this is Fada'il. Yes. But why 1,000? Why not 2,000? Why not 3,000? Why not 5,000?
Because I think the average age of the human being is 83.
Exactly. Not 83. 83 point something is the total. Is the total. But there's a hadith that say, the Prophet says, the average age of my ummah is between 60 to 70. And those who cross more than 70, like Mahadir, can become 93. Only few can cross 60 to 70. But on average at least. So if you have that layla, that one night, it's equal to your entire life. Entire life. Because the previous generation, they live for 900 years. Okay? And out of Allah's rahmah to this ummah, because we don't live longer, He gives us one day which is equivalent to their entire life. Can you imagine His rahmah? So likewise, you have 6 days, you must fast it. Isn't it? If you fast the 6 days, it's as if you fast what?
1 year.
1 full year. Demand. In other words, another? Why? Why 1 full year?
It's 10 days each. 6 days.
Now?
It's 1 year, right? That is the
yes. Why he says that if you fast six, the six, you fast Ramadan followed by the 6 days as if you fast the whole year.
Yeah.
The mother. Why? Okay, this I give you as a homework. Yeah, because it will bother your mind, homework, then I'll come and tell you this. Okay? So, inshallah, as I told you, again to remind you, please, for your final exam with me, you have only 15 marks for the exam. And I don't want a bookish answer. Don't go and memorize books. It's not about books, it's about how you argue, how you argue your case. And many people will have different answers. But one thing I want to tell you, please, when you answer, there's something called assumption. Do we know assumption? What's an assumption? What's an assumption?
Perception that you have something.
Perception.
Now you're doing what the Arab says to first of ma bin ma. What is water? Water is ma. What is ma? Ma is ayin. Okay. Assumption is part of the truth. For example, if students are absent in the class, they're absent because of what? They may be sick, traffic jam, what?
Walking,
walking, maybe
sleeping.
Sleeping. Laziness.
Laziness, yeah.
Yeah, okay? All these are true. These are true, right? So if you want to discuss only one of these truths, you said assuming there was a traffic light or there was a traffic jam, then you discuss. Are you with me? So when you answer exam questions, you have to invoke a lot of assumptions if you want your teacher to appreciate your work. Don't swim everywhere where I don't know which. You have to assume. Say that I'm taking this position, assuming that this is what it is, my view is this. Then you become very clear. But don't sit just right. Then I'm trying to find you in the forest. It becomes very difficult. Yeah. Because you may have the answer, people will have different assumptions. Okay? Different assumptions. So please put this in the back of your mind that you need to make those assumptions. And finally, since we started teaching this course, nobody has failed. But please don't make a mistake. I cannot stop you to do that. It's up to you, but I cannot stop you. So please, you work hard and you need just to articulate, discuss among yourselves issue. Believe me, it's usually the best thing I enjoy in teaching is not exam. I don't want to feel my, you know, my undergraduate courses, I don't have final exams. No final exams. I just give coursework because I want people to enjoy knowledge. You should not come here under tension when they mention exam. Some also will not want to go to the clinic. Exam, there's so much. You should not do that. Just no one is here. I love to learn. I have this. That should be it. Okay? So, inshallah, I wish you all the best. I think next class you'll have Dr. Maya. But please, really, it's a lot of shortcomings. I know because of the time constraint. If you have anything that you want to ask me regarding this thing, you want to email me, send anything regarding the concept, the calculations, what, please feel free, okay? Anytime, inshallah, I'll respond to you, okay? You have my email, right?
Yes.
Okay, good. So feel free, inshallah, I'll respond, okay? Jazakumullah, okay?